welcome to the next lecture, that is on the same transmission characteristics. So we have seen the different transmission characteristics in the previous two video lectures. So these are the learning outcomes. At end of this session, students will be able to calculate the attenuations in the optical signal here. So now in this lecture, we'll solve one example due to the Rayleigh's scattering here. So in the previous lecture, we have seen the losses due to the scattering here. So due to the scattering, there are two major problems, that is the linear and non-linear scattering. So in the linear scattering, we have seen that is the Rayleigh's and the Mie scattering. And in the non-linear, we have seen SRS, that is stimulated Raman scattering and the beryllium scattering here. So due to which the data is lost whenever there is a transmission through an optical cable here. So theoretically, we have to prove that if you go on increasing your the wavelength, your the Rayleigh scattering becomes less. Means we are going to see now the various wavelength at 0.63 micrometer, 1 micrometer and 1.3 micrometers, what will be the Rayleigh scattering. In the previous lecture also, we have seen how we are going to calculate the Rayleigh scattering here, that is the gamma r here. So just recall that formula that we have to use to solve this problem here today. Okay, so we'll switch over the for the problem now. So now this is the problem given to the students here. So the silica has an estimated the temperature of 1400 Kelvin and the isothermal compressibility of 7 into 10 raised to minus 11 meter square Newton per Newton. And the refractive index and the photoelastic coefficient for the silica are 1.46 and 0.286 respectively. So now we have to determine the theoretically attenuation in D B per kilometer. Due to the Rayleigh scattering at the various wavelength, that is 0.63, 1 and 1.30 micrometer. And for that solving this, we require the Boltzmann constant, which is given as 1.381 into 10 raised to minus 21 joules per Kelvin here. Recall that how you are going to solve for the theoretical attenuation in dB per kilometer due to the fundamental Rayleigh scattering here. So for that, we should know that it is being calculated, that is gamma r is equal to 8 pi cube n raised to 8 p square bc k tf upon 3 lambda raised to 4 here. So by using this formula, so we have to calculate the fundamental Rayleigh scattering here. So n is nothing but your refractive index here. So the refractive index is given as an 1.46 and the photoelastic coefficient, that is p, is equal to 0.286, and isothermal compressibility, that is given bc, is equal to 10 raised to minus 10 meter square per Newton, and the temperature is given as 1400 Kelvin, and we have to find out the lambda on various lambda, that is lambda 1, lambda 2 and lambda 3, which is 0.63, 1.0 and 1.3 micrometer. So by putting all this value into this, so we will solve for the Rayleigh scattering for the wavelength lambda 1, that is 0.63 micrometer here. So now if you substitute all the values into this for the lambda 1, so you will get 8 into pi into cube, means what you will get, for 248.15 into n is 1.46, that is raised to 8, it will be 20.65 into 0.82 into 7 into 10 raised to minus 11 into 1.38 10 raised to minus 3 into 1400 upon 3 into 0.63 micrometer cube. So if you solve this, so it will be 1.895 into 10 raised to minus 28 upon lambda 4. So for ease, so we are going to keep the lambda 4 only. We are not going to substitute the value here right now. So we'll solve this. That is at wavelength of 0.63 micrometer. So your Rayleigh's constant will be 1.895 into 10 raised to minus 28 upon, so it is lambda raised to 4, so it will be 0.158 into 10 raised to minus 24, which will be 1.199 into 10 raised to minus 3 meter, okay, per meter. So this is the Rayleigh's this Rayleigh scattering. So now we will see the transmission loss factor for 1 kilometer of fiber, that is in kilometers, so it, which is given by e raised to minus yr into l. So it will be minus 1.199 into 10 raised to minus 3 into 10 raised to 3, so which will be 0.301. So now the attenuation due to Rayleigh's scattering in dB per kilometer is calculated, that is attenuation 10 log to the base 10 1 upon in kilometer what we have drawn, it is 10 log to the base 3, okay, so which is equals to 5.2 dB per kilometer. So for 0.63 micrometer, your attenuation due to Rayleigh scattering in dB per kilometer is 5.2 dB per kilometer here. In the similar fashion, so we have to solve for the wavelength at lambda 2, that is 1.0 micrometer. So Rayleigh scattering is, we have calculated 1.895 into 10 raised to minus 28 divided by, that is 1 into 10 raised to minus 24, that is lambda value is 1 here, so it will be same because it is lambda raised to 4 here, so which is given by 1.895 into 10 raised to minus 4 per meter. So similarly, coefficient is calculated exp, that is exponential minus yr into l, so which is given by exponential minus 1.895 into 10 raised to minus 4 into 10 raised to 3, so which is 0.82, okay. So the attenuation due to Rayleigh's scattering in dB per kilometer is given by attenuation 10 to the log base, that is 1.209, which is 0.8 dB per kilometer. So this is 0.8 dB per kilometer, and due to the lambda 1 it is 5.2 dB per kilometer here. So now at wavelength 1.30 micrometer, So your railing scattering will be 8.95 into 28, 2.856 into 10 raised to minus 24 is equal to 0.64 into 10 raised to minus 4. You will get, then calculate coefficient EXP into minus R into L. So which will be EXP 0.4664 into 10 raised to minus 4 into 10 raised to 3. So which is 0.936. And attenuation due to Rayleigh scattering in dB per kilometer, 10 log to the base 10, 1.069, which is 0.3 dB per kilometer. So from clearly we can say that if you go on increasing your lambda, your the attenuation will go on less, as we have seen in the for lambda 1 0.63 your attenuation comes to be 5.2 dB. And if you make use of this 1 micrometer, so it will be 0.8. And for lambda 3, so if you make 1.3 micrometer, so your attenuation becomes 0.3 dB per kilometer. It is clearly that if you go on increasing your wavelength, your attenuation goes on becoming less here. So these are my references. Thank you.